chew it.
On this hunt, we're in Utah, on Antelope Island, going after the American bison. This tag is coveted, a once-in-a-lifetime pull. The person with the tag in their pocket is Kirstie Butler, who is half or even two times younger than most who would pull this tag, a fact that the others in on the hunt were all too aware of.
I can't believe you drew this tag. This is...
I can't either.
I guess how the hell? People wait like 25 years for this hunt.
What are the odds? Like, at
27
points.
It's insane. It's insane. She's a tag. Like, that is people wait their whole life to shoot the buffalo.
Kirstie is not alone on this hunt. She's backed by a village. Accompanied by family, friends, and even her taxidermist, there are many shared years of experience on this hunt, and they're all ready to help. The way this hunt is structured, a resident wildlife biologist accompanies you. They point you in the right direction and try to put you on older bulls who don't have as much breeding years in front of them. And those bulls become more susceptible to attempts at fleeing the island by way of water, which usually doesn't end well for them. The wildlife biologist in our case is Steve Bates, the wildlife manager at the island, who not only has a PhD, but 25 years of experience. Steve lets us in on an older bull he'd been studying and which had been frequenting the area. He estimated the bull to be between 8 and 10 years old. Knowing this, we quickly set off in search of the bruiser. It didn't take us long to spot a pair of bulls feeding out on a nearby hillside. It didn't take more than setting his glass on the animal for Steve to recognize the old bull and green light a stalk.
broadside
on account of the animals not being all too fast and covered with a coat, which is a stark contrast to their surroundings. Bison aren't overly elusive. They tend to rely on a few different strategies to evade hunters. They would bunch up together, taking away your shot, and the patterning in which they moved put folds in the land and snowdrifts between us. When the animals finally did settle to allow for a shot, they were directly underneath the sun, and combined with the ripping wind and snowdrifts, Kirsty's sight picture was less than ideal, resulting in a clean miss. She quickly calmed her nerves, and we watched the bison travel up a far slope. After studying their movements, we came to the decision of leaving one man behind to watch the herd, while the rest of us set out on a stalk. Got closer, it became painstakingly clear that we wouldn't catch them before they reached the rise of the slope. So we made a straight line to a rock outcrop, skylining the ridge that would give us good cover and an overview of the land lying beyond, which the bison were heading for. As they crested the hills, Kirsty quickly found herself face to face with a pair of bulls, as they had nestled themselves between the rocks, using the natural geography as a windbreak to the plains around. Kirsty quickly set up and got the older bull in her sights. She watched them for several minutes without shooting, as the old bull was quartering to her and she wisely held off on a shot. A bad shot picture on an animal of that size, with an anatomy different from most animals she was familiar with, was wisely avoided. Once the animals passed behind cover, Kirsty quickly repositioned. She moved to a spot that, when the animals passed from cover, would present her with a clear shot. Which is exactly what happened. When the bulls reappeared, they presented Kirsty with a perfect broadside shot. She quickly settled in and picked out the older bull. The shot was perfect, a clean hit to the lungs. Thank you. emotions in the air when we approached the down bowl were tangible. Kirsty wasn't the only one beside herself, as she had many loved ones living vicariously through her. The bowl was massive. Its years shone in the rubbed-off patches of its coat and in the scars and worn tips of his horns. It was an old warrior. After seeing the animal on the ground, Steve reaffirmed his belief of it being an older bull in the 8 to 10-year-old range, the type that get antsy and attempt to leave the island, ultimately drowning themselves. The prospect of field butchering a bull of that size was daunting, but with the amount of hands we had on board, we quickly hit a rhythm. It was amazing to see the amount of meat which came off the old bull. It seemed that no matter how much we cut, there was still more lying beneath. This island has a history of sustainment. It was named by John C. Fremont for the animals that sustained him and Kit Carson the first time they ventured there. The buffalo were moved there by John Dooley in a time which buffalo were all but gone from the plains. This was a conservation effort so that Utah may sustain bison again one day. And now, Kirsty has a freezer full of one of the 12 original bison's descendants that will sustain her for months to come, in the very same way that they have been sustaining people in the West for centuries.